Let's take a look at creating this model, which I actually found on the SolidWorks subreddit. We are going to focus on two features here. Creating this opening that goes from the side of this block to the base, maintaining the same wall thickness throughout. Also, we will take a look at creating these ribs. We want to be able to create the ribs such that they can conform to the curved faces but not protrude to the other side. We are going to start with this solid, which is basically a disc with a cylinder and a small block extruded on the side. Fillets have been added as such. This will be the starting file available for download. To get the through opening, it is possible to create a cut from this face of the block and then another cut from the base. Using that method, it might be difficult to line up the cuts, so let's take a look at using the shell command instead. Go to Modify, Shell. Remove the tangent chain option so that we can select faces individually. Select the base and this face. Adjust the thickness. So this action hollows out the whole model and at the same time creates an opening from the base to the side of this block. This looks pretty good, but upon comparison to the final model, there is a slight difference in the openings. In the final model, the opening actually extends beyond the front of the block. We can simply perform an extruder cut on this face. For the sake of discussion, let's explore another method. Can we actually do something before the shell command? Let's delete the shell. In order to give more control during the shelling process, we often need to create split faces. I have prepared a sketch rectangle here that aligns with the block. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select this face to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the sketch. Begin a shell command. Remove the tangent chain option and select these faces. Adjust the thickness. We do have an extended opening, but the walls here do not line up. Perhaps we need to take into account the shell thickness when creating the sketch. You can try to adjust the sketch such that it is one wall thickness away from both sides of the block. But if you try shelling with this split face, the shell command would give an error. So let's come back to this sketch. I found that the only way for this sketch to work is to shell on the outside. Go back into the shell command. Change the direction to outside. You will need to enter the thickness again. This time round, the walls line up. So the way shelling on the outside works is that it creates an outer skin on the original model. This increases the overall size of the model. So you will need to do some prior planning to ensure that the final dimensions after shelling are what you actually need. Next, let's take a look at creating the ribs. First, I'm going to create the boss. we can create concentric circles and extrude to the base. But let's try using the web command instead. First, we want to create a construction plane that is in line with the top of the boss. Go to Construct, Offset Plane. Select the base and adjust the offset. Begin a sketch on this plane. When using the web command, we do not need concentric circles. Line up the center of the circle with the origin. Go to Create, Web. Select the sketch as a profile. For thickness direction, set to symmetric so that it thickens on either side of the sketch line. For extent type, set to next. Adjust the thickness. The boss extends all the way down to the curved face. For the rib, we will be using the rib command. In the case of ribs, the thickening happens in a direction that is perpendicular to the sketch plane. So we need to perform the sketch on the back plane. Let's go to the sketch palette and turn on the slice option. This gives us a cross-sectional view that cuts across the sketch plane. When I first attempted this sketch, I actually drew the sketch line through the boss, thinking that the rib command would be smart enough to avoid the boss opening. But that was not the case. So you do need to draw the lines on either side of the boss. We need to use the boss as a reference. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersect. Select the cylindrical face of the boss. This projects two lines that represent the intersection between the boss and the sketch plane. Click on Locate to return to a view normal to the sketch plane. I'm going to draw a horizontal line on this end. And a vertical line on this end. These two segments are important in guiding the rib command, telling it how to extend. You can choose to attach it to the faces, but I'm going to leave them hanging in order to show how the rib command works. I will leave this sketch for you to define. Go to Create, Rib. Select the sketch line as a profile. Unfortunately, we are not able to select multiple entities. For thickness direction, set to symmetric so that it thickens symmetrically. For extent type, select up to next. Adjust the thickness. If it does not look right, flip the direction. So the command extends the rib all the way down and to the side. Repeat the same step for the next line. Lastly, perform a circular pattern. Go to Create, Pattern, Circular Pattern. Set object type to Features. Select the web and rib features from the timeline. Set the y-axis as the axis.